as we carry on with the progress of this Stirling Mark IV, this is the underwing. As you can see, this applies strips as per the instructions. They don't necessarily come off the sprue all that well, to be honest. I don't like the fit. These aren't glued in place. They do go in a specific way, but unfortunately one or two of the corners are rounded off. I don't know why they just didn't give us blank pieces, because they look ugly. And that is the same with the, there we go, under the fuselage there, long strips. This would have been better if it had been all one piece with the panel lines in place. It's not gone down well at all. I'm not a fan of that. But the rest of it is going on fine. We've got vertical stabilizer and the rudder on. That just needs some more paint work doing on it. But that I'm not keen on. Even though I've got to glue it in place, it's going to be difficult filling these here where it's rounded off a little bit. And I'm not sure if it's worth it, to be honest, because they don't actually sit flush with each other. I suppose they're supposed to look that way because it was a bomb at one time and it's not now. And they've just put those blanks on to cover the well, where the bombs would go. But it looks, I'm not keen on it. Those are the upper wings. They look fine. That's dark earth. And also we have the other lower wing, and there we have one of the ailerons. This one needs to be black. There we go, those are those strips now glued in place, so there is a little bit more work to be done. All those strips are in place now. I have put some filler on this one and I've been rubbing down due to a bit of excess glue. They do look a lot better than what I thought they would be. Once this is set, give it another rub down and give it a paint. So it's looking better than I thought it would be. Okie doke, well, I decided to remove these bomb bay panels because they just did not fit right. There was not enough support, and they didn't look right at all. So I've taken them off and I'm going to leave this open. I've left the side ones on here, the curved end pieces here, but this I'm just going to repaint and leave it as it is. As for the other part of the wings, you can see the line, the panel lines are missing, so I'm gonna have to scribe some panel lines in there, get these edges right. This one here, this one's partly missing, and here, and same with this one. I need to rub this down again. I took this end panel out to try and get it a better fit. I won't say it's any different than it was before, to be honest. So I need to rub that down. There is a bit of a gap here, but so is there on this one as well. There you go. It's not a problem because it's painted better. But these aren't too bad. But I can enhance the panel lines anyway, for the bomb bay doors, make it look more acceptable. But I'll leave them on. As for the upper part of the fuselage, I just need to enhance this panel line here. So once I've got the correct tool for that, that'll get done, and then it will look a lot better. That is the fuselage completed for now, more or less. A little bit of paint on here and that is it. Excellent stuff. And through that doorway you can actually see, there you go, the other components. The door's on the inside. That's deliberately left like that, just so as you can see the detail inside. That's pretty cool. It's not a bad kit really, just these are a nightmare, absolute nightmare, and they just look ugly as sin. So that is the fuselage up to now, virtually complete, just a bit of paint, and we're on our way to assembling the rest of the plane. I hope you like that. I will see you again soon. Bye for now.